You know what's better than cool free programs? Cool free portable programs, meaning you don't have to install them, you can just run the file and it's good to go. Later on, I can go over some reasons why I do prefer these two installed programs, and no, they're not just for putting on your flash drive. But anyway, let's just get right into it. I've got 11 of them in no particular order. There's quite a variety in what they do, and while these mostly will be for Windows, many do support multiple operating systems. And of course, I'll put the links in the description. So let's go. Starting off with number one, for anyone out there with a Logitech mouse, you may know that Logitech has their clunky, bloated software for changing the settings and button bindings, but they also have a portable tool called Logitech Onboard Memory Manager that is just one file and lets you set up profiles and buttons without having to install anything. You can just have it save the settings onto the mouse itself, so it's not even like you need to keep running the tool. I was so happy when I found out about this one. Next up is one of my longtime favorites, Bulk Rename Utility. You may have heard me talk about it in the past, and just like the name suggests, it makes it really easy to rename as many files as you want in pretty much every way imaginable. I know the interface looks overwhelming at first, but it's not as complicated as it seems. You just select a bunch of files in the Explorer at the top, then each section at the bottom is just a different way to change the file names. But it's not like you need to set every single one. You only have to set the ones you want to use, and 99% of the time, the basic ones are enough. For example, there's a section to replace certain text with different text wherever it appears. There's also a section to remove characters from the beginning or end of all the file names or anywhere in between, and a section to add prefixes and suffixes too. There's even one specifically for adding numbering in various formats. I don't have time to go over them all, and it's not like I've used them all anyway, but I bet it will come in handy. Just note that to get the portable version of it, you just have to choose that option on the download page. Now, before I get to number three, I've got something else that's really cool. Today's sponsor, Ugreen, and their brand new line of state-of-the-art chargers, the Nexode Pro series. For example, here are the Ugreen Nexode Pro 100-watt and 160-watt chargers. The 100-watt charger has two USB-C and one USB-A ports, and it can indeed provide the entire 100 watts through a single port. It can even charge a MacBook Pro 14-inch from 0 to 50% in just 27 minutes. And thanks to Ugreen's new technology called Air Pyrotech, plus the latest GaN Infinity chips, the Nexode Pro 100-watt charger is so compact that it's similar in size to the regular Nexode 65-watt charger. Compared to the regular Nexode 100-watt charger, that gives the Pro a 37% increase in power density. And of course, you are able to split the 100 watts among all three ports to charge three devices at once, anything from laptops to tablets or watches. As for the Nexode Pro 160-watt charger, it has three USB-C and one USB-A port, and it can deliver a whopping 140 watts to a single port. That makes it able to, again, in just 27 minutes, charge a larger 16-inch MacBook Pro from 0 to 50%. Also, thanks to the same new AirPyro technology and GaN Infinity chips, the 160-watt Nexode Pro is similar in size to the 140-watt regular Nexode charger. That's a 20% increase in power density. While still fitting in the palm of your hand, you can charge up to four devices at once, from a smartphone to a MacBook Pro, meaning you can finally replace all those gigantic AC adapters and charging bricks. So be sure to check out the Ugreen Nexode Pro 100 and 160-watt chargers, as well as the rest of the Nexode Pro series. I'll put some links in the description you can visit to learn more. And with all that being said, let's continue. All right, next up, number three is a program many of you have heard of, but probably didn't realize there's a portable version, and that is OBS Studio, the streaming software. This one's easy to miss because on the main page, if you click one of the buttons for your operating system, it immediately starts the download for the installer. But if you instead go to the download links at the top, you'll see more options, including one called Download Zip, which is the portable version. After extracting it, to run it, you just go into the bin folder, short for binaries, then 64-bit, then run the main executable, obs64.exe. And it works like normal. The one extra note, if you want it to store the settings in this same folder, you have to create a file called portable_mode.txt and just put it there, and then it will store the settings here too. Now, one tip I want to emphasize, which you've just seen twice now, is that you will often see software like that, where by default they offer the installer to download, but there's an extra option for a portable version elsewhere. As you saw, sometimes it's literally called the portable version, and other times it's often called the zip version because all the files are just in a zip folder, but it's the same thing. Okay, now on to number four, we have WizTree. This one is super cool. It lets you visually see what is taking up space on your storage drives with just a quick glance. For example, literally as I was making this video, I realized that my Adobe After Effects cache folder was taking up almost 100 gigabytes. I also have a ton of huge files in my downloads folder that I don't need, like a bunch of Windows ISOs I was using in past videos. WizTree is also really fast at scanning the disks, much faster than similar old software you may have heard of, like WindirStat, which is what I used before I found this. All right, moving on to number five, we have a tool called ValiDrive, which I actually made a video about a few months ago. Basically, it lets you see if your USB flash drive actually has the capacity it claims or if it's fake. Lately, there have been USB drives sold on Amazon that claim to be a terabyte or more, but really are just 64 gigabytes, and have their firmware hacked to show the fake amount in Windows. This can lead to all sorts of possible file loss that I won't get into. You can just watch the original video for details. Anyway, how this tool works is you plug in your drive, and then it tests a bunch of sectors throughout the drive, and it shows how much of it is real or fake. One cool fun fact about this software is notice how absolutely tiny it is, under 100 kilobytes. That's because the creator, Steve Gibson of Gibson Research, actually wrote the whole thing in assembly language by hand. And for those of you who know what that means, I don't need to tell you why that's impressive. Okay, now up to number six, we have OpenRGB. This is a really cool program I actually use every day, and what it does is lets you control the RGB lighting of your computer, like inside your case, and also some attached devices, like your mouse, for example. In my opinion, this is so much better than having to install the typical software required to control it from your motherboard manufacturer, which is often extremely bloated and full of unnecessary junk. OpenRGB might not be able to do as much fancy stuff, but if you just want basic effects, it works fine. I personally only use it for the most basic use of controlling my PC case lights, but it does apparently support lots of other devices too, so definitely worth checking out. All right, on to number seven is HXD, a free hex editor tool. Obviously, this one is more for advanced users, and I admit I've only used this a handful of times, but if you know what you're doing, it can come in handy for certain situations. Usually, this is when you might want to look at the raw data of some file, like maybe if you have a file with corrupted headers. With this, you might be able to see what is the problem. One example is this WAV audio file from a project I was working on that had a weird popping sound at the start. And if you open it in the hex editor, turns out that somehow the file got a partly duplicated header. You can see this riff bit twice when compared to the good file. In this case, you can basically just see the same if you open it up simply in Notepad, but sometimes the hex values can help you spot things. Okay, on to number eight, we have OpenSpeedTest. I made a video about this a little while ago, but it's an open source program that really makes it easy to test your local network speed, like between computers within your own home. In addition to downloading through the various app stores, you can also just download an EXE, and when it's running, it allows any local devices to connect to it and run a speed test just through a web interface without having to install anything on the other device. It even tells you what address to use. This one could be helpful for diagnosing network issues or making sure the connection between two devices is fast enough for doing something like streaming a video from your computer to phone via Wi-Fi or whatever. All right, we still got a few more, and number nine is Visual Studio Code Portable Mode. Visual Studio Code is a program created by Microsoft made for, well, coding, though not to be confused with the much bigger program called Visual Studio. VS Code isn't a whole IDE or integrated developer environment like regular Visual Studio, but rather more of an advanced text editor that can also run certain types of code like Python scripts. Like other software, it usually is installed, but if you go to the downloads page, you'll see a zip download option. With this, there is one more step to use the portable mode, which is to create a data folder within the main directory. Then it will see that and will put all the settings and stuff into that folder. Otherwise, it will go into the app data folder just like the regular installed version. Also, be aware that it won't auto-update like the installed version. We're now up to number 10, which is HW Monitor, short for Hardware Monitor. The name is pretty self-explanatory. It simply lets you see a whole bunch of information from your computer's hardware sensors and other hardware info. This includes stuff like the various core temperatures of your CPU and other devices, or the current clock speed of your CPU cores. Plus, it can show you stuff like GPU, CPU, and memory utilization. You can probably imagine cases where this might be useful. Okay, finally, for number 11, I'm just going to combine a whole bunch into one, and those would be all the tools in the Microsoft SysInternal suite and any tools from Nearsoft. There are way too many from these to even mention, literally hundreds, and many of you probably know about these anyway, so I'll keep it quick. I've made a dedicated video about both of them if you want to see more specifics though. The SysInternal suite is a bunch of tools published by Microsoft that are super useful, especially for troubleshooting, though they can be very advanced. A couple popular examples would be Process Explorer and Process Monitor, which I've used on many occasions. Then there are all the tools from NearSofer of Nearsoft, which are a ton of random tools each dedicated to some specific task in Windows. Some of my favorites are USB LogView for monitoring the USB devices that are being plugged in or unplugged, and Full Event View Log, where you can see every event from all Windows Event Viewer logs in one place, for when maybe you want to search for some error logs, but don't know what category it would be in under Event Viewer. I'll put the links to the videos I made before about these in the description as well. Okay, now that you know a bunch more cool portable programs, you might be wondering why you might want to use these versions instead of the installed ones. Once again, this is actually a topic I went into in more detail in a separate video, but there are two main big reasons for me at least. First, it's great for software that you might only use once in a blue moon, but you don't want to install it and further bloat up your computer. With this, you can just keep a bunch of portable programs in some folder, and they just sit there until they're needed. The other main reason is for whenever you get a new computer or reformat your current one. Any software you have that's portable is one less program you need to reinstall and reconfigure to how it was before. And it's great if you use a cloud drive to sync files between computers, like Dropbox or OneDrive, because any changes to preferences and stuff will update across all your devices too. So for these reasons, whenever I go to download a program, I usually check to see if there's a portable version and decide whether it makes more sense to get that one based on how I expect to use it. And now you should be even more well equipped with these cool new tools, and you don't even need to install any of them. I would be curious which of these are your favorite, or maybe you think I should have included other tools. We can talk about that down in the comments. Thanks again to Ugreen for sponsoring. Definitely check out their new Nexode Pro 100 and 160 watt chargers and the rest of the Ugreen Nexode Pro series. Links in the description. If you want to keep watching, what I'll do is put links to the videos with all those tools from SysInternals and Nearsoft. You can just click on those right there if you're interested. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.